Let's start. Okay. We were discussing about EIGRP messages, right? Was we already discussed about neighborship. Hope you already cleared, like how they perform the neighbor, how they become the neighbor, how they perform the neighborship, how the router becomes the neighbor. If I talk about in the respect of EIGRP. Clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So today we are going to discuss about the update message. Okay.
Okay.
So let's start the update message. Suppose our scenario is like we are having two router like this, R1 and R2. It's our R1, it's our R2. Now, what happens when I just enable the EIGRP over here, and between the R1 and R2, I'm using the network of 12.1.1.0.0.24. There is a network connected behind the R1. It's like 10.1.1.0, 10.1.2.0, and 10.1.3.0. Okay. This network is running behind the R1. Now, first they share hello message with each other. It's like this. They will share hello message. After that, they will perform neighborship. They become the neighbor, like R1 will maintain a neighbor table like 12.1.1.2 is my neighbor. And R2 will maintain its neighbor table like 12.1.1.1 is my neighbor. Okay. After that, they shared some update message. Okay. There will be two updates. Which is your null update? Okay. These null update will unicast just to verify your neighbor. Okay. Okay. So there will be no information about the prefixes in your null updates. Then after that, they will share the prefix information in update message. These update message will be multicast. Okay, I'm talking about like multi-access segment. These update message will be multicast. Okay, after the sharing the update message, they maintain topology table. In the topology table, R1 and R2 will maintain the information about successor and feasible successor. Some information will carried about like successor and feasible successor. Suppose R1 sharing the update message regarding the prefix 10.1.1.0. So regarding the prefix information 10.1.1.0, R2 carries the information like if it's having a successor or feasible successor, it will carry like there is a successor and there is a backup path if available. In case R2 is receiving a same prefix by using two different neighbor, so what it will do, it will maintain the topology table like there is a successor and there is a feasible successor. Successor will be your best path and feasible successor will be your backup path. When the successor goes down, feasible successor will take place of the successor. Okay. If I talk about the another IGP protocol, like I hope you already know about RIP. If I compare this feature with the RIP, suppose our scenario is like this. Okay, so here it's like my R1, here it's my like R2, here it's like R3. These are connected like this. Okay, suppose behind the R1 there is a network connected of, behind the R1, suppose there is a connected network like 10.1.1.0. Same prefixes connected with R2 directly, like 10.1.1.0. Now, in this case, what happened? Same prefix information will forward towards the R3 via R1. So, R3 will receive a network information like 10.1.1.0. Okay, via R1, and if it's using the RIP, then what will be the ID value? Hello?
120.
Okay, very good. 120. In this scenario, what will be the metric?
Hop count, right? Only one.
Good. Okay. The same prefix will advertised or will received with the update message by R3, like there is a prefix of 10.1.1.0 via R2, AD value 120,
same.
And metric will be same. So the both prefixes, first the R3 will take is the prefix are different or the same. So it's a different, so it's the same prefix. It's the same from R1 and R2, I'm receiving a same prefix. Then after that, what I will check? I will check the prefix length. Okay, so the prefix length also same. Then what I will check? I will check AD.
AD
is also same. Then I will check metric. Metric is also same. So what the R3 will do? R3 will maintain the routing table like there are two prefixes like 10.1.1.0. It's connected via R1 and R2 both. So maybe it will try for load sharing. Clear? But suppose in this case, from R2, it's receiving the prefix with the metric 2. Just suppose. Okay. Then what it will do? It will check first prefix length, which is same, prefix and prefix length, which is same. Then it will check AD, which is also same. Then it will check metric, which is lower metric. From which path I find out like the prefix coming from a lower metric by using R1. So it will store the prefix like 10.1.1.0 with CIDR value connected via R1 in its routing table. Clear? Now suppose behind the R3 there is a user connected like this. Okay, now on the 10 network there is a PC connected like 10.1.1.1. Now this PC want to perform the communication with 10.1.1.1. First, this PC will forward data towards its default gateway. That means the data received by the R3. R3 will check the destination is your 10.1.1.1. So regarding this prefix, R3 will check its routing table first. So in its routing table, it will check 10.1.1.0 is connected by R1. So it will forward your data towards the R1. Clear? Now, in the RIP, router share the update message periodically in every 30 seconds, right?
Yes, sir.
So, just suppose R1 and R2 just share the update message with the R3, and R3 receive two updates like this and like this from R1 and R2. Now, what I'm going to say, suppose this prefix goes down. This path goes down.
Down.
Then what happened? R3 will wait the upcoming update message, which will come after 30 seconds. And in between, suppose this PC want to perform the communication. Will there will be any entry in its routing table? Suppose this prefix goes down or this path goes down. What the R3 will do? R3 will remove that prefix in its routing table exact the same time. So there will be no entry in its routing table regarding the prefix 10.1.1.0. But after some second, or we can say after a couple of time, it will receive another update message from the R2. So what the R3 will do? R3 will maintain its routing table like the network of 10 is connected via R2 because it goes down. So there will be some delay occurred. Right? But if I talk about EIGRP, what happened in EIGRP? Suppose our topology is like this. Like my R1. Select my R2, select my R3, select my R4. Suppose behind the R1, some prefixes are running like 40.1.1.0 with CIDR value 24. Okay. In that case, just wait for a minute. So let's start it again. Okay, now suppose our topology is like this. We were discussing about the update message. Okay, so in this scenario, R4 will first let's update the neighbor table, like R1 become the neighbor with R2 and R3. If I talk about the R2, R2 will become the neighbor with R1 and R4. If I talk about the R3, R3 will become the neighbor
R1
of
R1 and R4.
R1 and R4. If I talk about the respect of R4, R4 will become the neighbor of R2.
R2, R3.
R3. Right. So after
managing the neighbor table, what the R1 will do, R1 will advertise the connected prefix information like this.
Yeah.
So in the update, just suppose R4 sharing the 40 prefix information in its update. Okay. So here R2 will receive the 40.1.1.0 prefix information.
Yes.
R3 will also receive the 40.1.1.0 prefix information.
Yes.
Okay.
This will update.
Yeah. And R3 is neighbor with R1 and it's receive update from R4. So it will forward this update to its neighbor R1. So
R1 will be
the updates. So R1 will have 40.1.1.0 network information from R3.
Okay.
The same over here. R1 will receive 40.1.1.0 information from R2. Clear. Now, regarding the destination prefix in the topology table, they maintain a topology table, and in the topology table, they maintain some FD and RD. And what is the FD and what is the RD? FD is your feasible distance, which is like your complete metric, total metric.
Yep.
Okay, so suppose the FD calculated by the R2 is like 250. Just suppose. Okay, over here, the FD is calculated by the R3. It's like, might be 350. Okay. The metric calculated by the R4, which would be FD for this prefix, suppose it's 100. So RD over here would be 100 and RD over here would be 100. RD was total metric from the neighbor. So who's its neighbor? R4. From the R4, its FD is 100. So my RD will be 100.
How you calculate your FD, feasible distance?
FD, we already discussed the formula.
Ah, yeah, the same formula, but the 10 to the power of 7 by lowest bandwidth.
Yeah.
Okay.
And cumulative
delay. No, I heard, before I read that how the FD will be calculated is like total cost from the local router to the destination.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yeah. Actually, what they do, they share its own metric. The destination is connected to me by using this metric, and they will calculate the destination metric by using the formula, same formula, and add the metric which coming from the neighbor. Like this. Okay,
got it, sir.
Okay, so what happened over here? Where we were? Okay, FD and RD. So now suppose R1 receive 40.1.1.0 prefix information. Okay. Over here, it will calculate a FD and RD. Suppose FD is like 400.
Okay.
And RD would be 250 coming from the R2. So total metric of is this one here in the respect of R1. So the FD would be, just suppose, 500. Okay. And the RD is like, what would be the RD?
350.
Yeah, 350. Right. Okay. So what happened? In this case, it's a topology table and it's a topology table. So in the topology table, R1 will maintain a feasible successor and a successor information in topology table. First one would be your successor, that means a main path, and there will be a backup path. So first it will check the prefix, which is same. Then it will check the ID. Both are coming from the EIGRP, and the ID would be 90, just suppose. So then after that, it will check metric. The metric coming, when the prefix coming from R2 is 400. When the prefix coming from the R3, the metric is 500, which is lower. 400. So in the routing table,
okay,
we'll maintain that 40.1.1.0 prefix information
via R2
is connected via R2 with AD90 and metric 400. Okay, so as I discussed, there will be in the topology, there will be two entry, like visible successor and the successor. So if I talk about the only topology table here like this, your successor would be 40.1.1.0.
Yeah.
Which having the FD
400
is this, and RD
250.
It's a topology table. Okay. There will be a feasible successor, but the path is coming from the R3, or there is an another path, suppose for the same prefix. This path will become feasible successor. It's depend on the scenario. There is a condition called as feasibility condition. The second path will become your backup path. It's depend on a scenario, or we can say depend on a condition. This condition called as feasibility condition. Okay. So
FD.
What is the feasibility condition? The FD of your path,
the FD of the successor should be greater than the AD of the feasible successor.
No.
Listen.
The FD of your backup path.
FD of the successor should be greater than AD of the feasible successor.
It's not like this. Actually, here it will check the RD first. I'm reversible. I'm just explaining it's reversible. It's easy to understand if it's reversible. Like the backup path RD will always be less than FD of successor.
So, yes.
It's easy to understand. Okay. If suppose there is a backup path, then it will check the backup path RD. It's 350. Is it less than FD of successor? Yes. Here in our scenario, the backup path RD is 350 and FD of successor is
400.
So it's match to our condition.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's not equal and greater than.
It should be lesser than.
Should be less than. There is, if suppose the both are the same, RD and FD of your successor. Now, this condition is matched by feasibility condition or not? It's matching by this or no? No. So, there will not become feasible success. So, but our scenario, it's matched with the condition. So, the second path will be like
40.1.0/25 500 with the AD
500 and the RD 350. Clear? So, the FD the successor information will come in routing table. Clear? It's routing table. Now what happened? Suppose this prefix goes down.
Okay.
This prefix goes down.
It will check the feasibility condition.
At Yeah. At the same time, feasible successor will become successor, and this prefix come in its routing table. Understand? When this prefix goes down, the feasible successor will come in its routing table as a successor. So feasible successor will become successor. Clear?
Clear.
Okay. Now we'll discuss about how they share the update message. Okay. Suppose it's my R1.
So in topology table, we have successor and feasible successor.
Yes, I'll show you. We'll take it practically. Okay. Suppose this one is our R1. There is another router, which is R1 and it's like R2. Over here I'm using the network 12.1.1.0 and here we are running some prefixes like 10.1.1.0, 10.1.2.0, 10.1.3.0. Okay, so what happened? First they perform the neighbor check, like 12.1.1.1 is my neighbor, or here like 12.1.1.1, it's like 2. Okay, there is an urgent call, I have to take it. Hello?
Yes.
Yeah. Can... there was an urgent call, so okay, let's discuss it again. What happened now? The share
neighbor table will be done.
Neighbors already they performed the neighborship. Now they will share the update message.
Yes,
first they share
null update. It's unicast,
it would be unicast. Then they'll share
they'll exchange routing table.
Yeah, now they will share the update message. In this update message, they will share the prefix information like 10.1.1.0 is a prefix, 10.1.2.0 prefix, 10.1.3.0 there is a prefix. Okay, now what happened with this update, it will share some information like there is a sequence number. Okay, there is a sequence number, suppose 1. Okay, so R1 will receive an update with the sequence 1. We have some reliable message in EIGRP like update, query, and reply.
Update, query, reply, acknowledge.
For these message, we generate an acknowledgement. Okay. So, acknowledgement having a sequence number. For which sequence number, for which message, we generate the acknowledge. So, these sequence number will be maintained by the neighbor also, that from which sequence number I received an acknowledge message. Okay, so let's check it out. So for the practical, I'm using GNU code here. take the axis of R1 and R2. R2. Vectors are like F0 by 0 and F0 by 0. So, interface. Over here, I'm going to configure the IP address. I'm going to do, I'm going to configure the EIGRP on both router, like router EIGRP. Router EIGRP. R1, I'm going to configure some loopback first. IP address 10.1.1.1. These are the loopback on R1. Clear? The IP address we configured over here, it's like do show IP interface brave. These IP address configured by us. Let's come to the R2. Here you can verify do show IP interface brave. Clear? Now, yep. What we are going to do, we are going to update, or we can say we are going to enable the routing process on interfaces. So to enable the routing process, I'm going to use the network command. And before using the network command, what I'm going to do, I'm going to capture the data. I'm going to capture the link between R1 and R2. Let's start it. The network command are like 12. Okay, I can use 0.0.0.0.0.0.0 or here. Okay.
Okay.
I hope you already know the meaning of 0.0.0.0.
It advertises everything.
Yeah. Every interface which configured by IPv4. Router EIGRP, then I'm using the network command as 0.0.0.0 here. Let's capture the traffic. Here you will see there are some update messages. Okay, now I'm going to stop this capture.
Mm-hmm.
Clear. First, as we discussed, they perform the neighborship by exchanging the hello. So first, they just share the hello message and they become the neighbor.
And when they become the neighbor, they maintain a neighbor table like this. Do show IP, EIGRP neighbor. Here you will see it's a neighbor table. There are some major information. Okay. So it's my neighbor, which is connected by using which interface? F0/0. And I'm going to hold this neighbor. How many seconds? 15 seconds. It's reducing with the seconds. Hold time is in second. By default, the hold down time is 15 seconds. And in every 5 seconds, I just receive a hello message. So I just update my hold timer as 15 seconds. Okay. How much time? And there is another timing which is SRTT. There is another timing which is RTO. There is a sequence number. Now, what is the mean of sequence number? First, we are going to discuss this. The last acknowledge I received from which sequence number?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we can check it, can verify. Suppose first they become the neighbor.
Okay.
Then R2 share a null update and R1 also share a null update. Suppose R1 sharing a null update over here. There is an acknowledge one and a sequence number one. Okay. So R2 will acknowledge them.
Okay.
With the same acknowledgement number. Okay. Now R1 share a update message.
Okay.
With the sequence number 2.
Acknowledge. Okay.
So it will acknowledge it on the same acknowledgement number. Okay, it's acknowledge for 2.
Oh,
it's an acknowledge. Clear. I hope it will again share a last acknowledged message. Yeah, it's like this. So which is sending with last acknowledged message?
3.
Sending by 12.1.1.1. So you come to the R2. What's R2? Do show IP EIGRP neighbor. I think it's 2. You know why it's 2? Cause the last acknowledge message sent via using which sequence number? So 12.1.1.1. Share an update message, and here you can see the sequence number. So it's, I think, null update. There will be another update. Here it is. Yeah, it's a sequence number 2.
So first it's sending an null update with a sequence number 1, and after that another update with a multicast, then it's that sequence number is 2, right?
Yeah. Suppose any prefix goes down.
Mm-hmm.
Over here, suppose any prefix goes down, it will update to whom? R1. And it will update by using a sequence number. So you can check it, you can verify it. Suppose I'm going to down the loopback one. Now you can check over here to show IP EIGRP neighbor. Okay, the sequence number is,
it will be incrementing, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
when again it come up like no shit, it will share a message. Mm-hmm. It will be an acknowledge message. So the last acknowledge message received via which sequence number? It's like this.
Okay, yeah. Got it.
Okay.
Okay.
Now come to the SRTT, which is in microsecond. Oh, sorry. It's in millisecond. It's a millisecond. Okay, so what is the mean of SRTT?
SRTT.
It's smooth round time. Okay, so what is it? Suppose R1 just it's like smooth round time.
Oh, smooth round time. Okay,
just suppose R1 just share an update message with the sequence. Like I just share a update message.
Okay.
With the sequence number 2. Just suppose. Okay. So what the R1 will do, R1 first in the neighbor table calculate a SRTT type.
Mm-hmm.
Which provide actually a reliability. How? It's calculate suppose 40 millisecond SRTT time. This time represent in which time I can assure that I will receive an acknowledgement from my neighbor. This time represent that in which time I can receive the acknowledgement from my neighbor. So every neighbor router maintain a SRTT time. Clear? Hello?
Yeah, not clear. Can you...
Suppose I just share an update message. It's a reliable message, we can say.
Yeah.
What we want an acknowledgement for this message. Okay.
Mm,
so
yes.
For the acknowledgement, how much time I will wait from my neighbor?
Okay.
So in which time R2 will capable enough to forward me the acknowledgement.
Okay. So 40 milliseconds.
So it will wait for 40 milliseconds. And what happen when I don't receive any acknowledgement from my neighbor after 40 milliseconds?
Okay.
What happened? So there is a condition like I just calculate my SRTT is 40 milliseconds.
Okay.
Suppose there are some congestion, or we can say some other problem in R2's interface. So R2 is not able to forward the acknowledgement regarding the sequence number or regarding this update message or regarding any reliable message. R2 is not able to forward the acknowledgement. So first, R1 will wait for SRTT time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that means 40 milliseconds. Then, the first update was multicast. It was multicast. So, what happened again? If I don't receive any acknowledgement from my neighbor with that message, what I will do? I will again share the update message.
Okay.
Okay, and this time it would be unicast. Okay. This time it would be unicast. Why it's do like this? Because suppose our scenario is like, let's take an example. Suppose there is a multi-axis segment like this. My R1, it's my R2, it's my R3. So what happened? R1 will maintain a neighbor table. In the neighbor table, R2 and R3 is my neighbor. If I talk about the R2, R1 and R3 will be my neighbor. If I talk about R3, R1 and R2 will my neighbor. Suppose behind the R1 there is a prefix running like 10.1.1.0. Just suppose there is a prefix running behind the R1 is like 10.1.1.0. Okay, now suppose to update its neighbor, R1 share an update message. This message will be multicast. Mm-hmm. It will receive via R2 and receive via R3. Okay. Now, R2 just acknowledge this message. Okay. Suppose in neighbor table, I just maintain the SRTT time like 40 second, and for R3 I just maintain like 40 millisecond. Clear? So it will assume that how much time in I will receive the acknowledge message from the R2. 40 millisecond. Suppose I receive an acknowledgement in that specific time, that's okay. But here R3 is not able to forward the acknowledge message. Might be there are some conjunction. So in this case, R1 will wait for 45 millisecond, wait for the acknowledgement from the R3. But okay, if suppose in that time I'm not going to receive any acknowledgement, so what I will do, I will again forward the same update message. But this time it will be unicast. Why I'm sending this message as unicast? Because from R2, I already received the acknowledgement. Okay, so this time I'm going to share this update as unicast. Just for the R3 only. Clear it is? Any doubt? Why I'm sharing its unicast second time? And it will share this unicast message, unicast update after 45 millisecond, after SRTT time. Okay. Now the condition is, suppose I just share the update message as unicast after SRTT time. What happen when I don't receive yet any acknowledgement from the neighbor? Now the condition is, still R2 not able to forward the acknowledgement. So what the R1 will do? R1 will check there is another protocol, which is RTO. Okay, so RTO, it's also a time.
Return time order.
Yes. So what it will do, it will wait for RTO time. In RTO time, if I receive the acknowledgement, that's okay. If I don't receive any acknowledgement from the neighbor, what I will do? I will again start the forwarding unicast message.
Okay, second time it will second like a null update, right?
It's not like null update. There is another timer, you can say.
Yeah, RTO.
RTO. In the RTO time, it will forward the unicast message again and again, again and again. How many times?
No, actually I have one doubt here. See, first when neighbor table is formed, and after it will send a null update, after followed by the multicast, right?
Null update would be unicast.
null update unicast, and after that followed by multicast. Okay, yes. So we have these, so SRTT has been set to 40 milliseconds. So if
it's not,
it is
like always 40 seconds, it's depend.
Oh, it varies.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like you can see, every router maintain its own SRTT time.
Okay.
And it could be where I, like here you can check it to show IP EIGRP. Neighbor, here you will see it's maintaining like 38. If we come to over here on R2, 39.
So within that SRTT time, it should receive an acknowledgement, correct?
Yes. But if in case not, it will wait for RTO time. In the RTO time, it will share the unicast message 16 times.
Yeah. Okay. This is not like an null update, but it will send a unicast message complete 16 times.
16 times.
RTO. Okay.
What happened? Still R2 not able to forward the acknowledgement. It will just flap your neighborship.
App means like it going up and down.
Will restart the neighborship.
Oh, it'll restart. Oh, again. It'll restart the neighborship.
What it will do, actually, it will increase your queue count. It will increase your
queue count. Queue yes, count.
There is a key. So it must be zero. Because it will again flip. You can see over here. It will flip the neighborship. When it will flip the neighborship, again they will perform the neighborship.
Okay.
They again start the send the update message.
Yeah.
Then again it will wait. Suppose this time it's not able to forward the acknowledgement. Then in the same scenario, it will again flip the neighborship. So it will increase the queue count.
So queue count is nothing but it's increasing the process again, the whole process.
Yes. Queue count is like, I'm just sharing we can say acknowledged message.
Hmm.
But how many times I can say, I just share the acknowledged message but not received. Any acknowledgement regarding the same. So that's the reason flapping the neighborship.
Okay. Queue count is just sending, keep sending the update message. How many times? Yes. For example, if it is sending like 5 times the update, the queue count.
Suppose I just face the problem 5 times. So the queue time will be increased one by one again and again when I face the same problem.
Okay.
I'm sure first they perform the neighborship, they are able to perform the neighborship, but they are not able to share the acknowledgement.
This is no related to the RTO because RTO will be keep sending 16 times, right?
Yeah.
Are you referring to that one?
It's a single process. It's a single process. It's a single queue count.
Oh, that, yeah, that is what I'm asking. Okay. It's a single queue count again. Okay. Got it now.
Complete process.
Complete process will be one, and after that again it will try to start sending it.
You cannot check it out on GNSS because there will be no queue count concept actually, because there is no congestion in our scenario.
Okay.
We cannot create such scenario, but in real time you will face the same issue many times.
Yeah. These type of issues will come. Yeah.
Okay. So let's. Okay, so it was our neighbor table. I hope the neighbor table is complete.
Yes.
Okay, now
the update table. Okay.
We already discussed the update message. Right?
Yeah.
Now today we'll discuss about the another messages, like query. Okay, the another messages. Any idea about the query message?
Query message.
Van, are you available? Van?
Yes, sir. I'm getting you.
Yeah. Okay. So, what is the mean of query message? Why we generate the query message in EIGRP? What was the use? Use cases of query message. Okay, what is the mean of query? Just explain me the query, mean of query. Might be you can message me anytime, like, sir, I have a query in EIGRP, right?
Can say it's a question. Something
yeah. Like it's not a question. I want something. Or we can say, I want to inform you something. Right? Or might be, I want to ask something.
Okay, requesting for information.
Yeah. Okay. So, this is the same scenario or the EIGRP. What happened? Suppose our scenario is like this. It's like my R1. It's like my R2. Okay. Now, behind the R1, there are some prefixes connected like 10.1.1.0. 10.1.2.0, 10.1.3.0. These prefixes are connected behind the R1. Suppose over here I'm using the network 12.1.1.0. The prefixes connected over here, it's like dot one and dot
two. One second.
Hello.
Sorry, I forgot to turn off the gas.
Okay. Now everything is okay now?
Yeah. That's why smell is coming. I don't know from where. I got scared.
Careful.
Might be Brian.
It's fine.
Okay. So. Okay, let's start. Suppose the connected prefix is like 12.1.1.0 over here and some prefixes of 10 like 10.1.1.0, 10.1.2.0, 10.1.3.0 connected with the R1. So the routing table of the R1 would be like this. There is a directly connected network of 10. Suppose it's a loopback one. There is a directly connected network of 10.1.2.0. Loopback 2. 10.1.3.0. Loopback 3. Okay. There is a directly connected network of 12.1.1.0. By using an interface like a 0 by 0. Just suppose. Routing table of R. Let's come to the R2. There will be a directly connected network of 12.1.1.0. Suppose it's your F0 by 0. Clear. Now what happened? Just suppose I just enable the EIGRP over here. And EIGRP over here. They just share the hello message. After sharing the hello message, they maintain the neighbor table. It's like my neighbor is whom? 12.1.1.2 is my neighbor by using which interface? F0 by 0 interface. Here the R2 will maintain the neighbor table. There is a neighbor 12.1.1.1 by using which interface? 0 by 0. Now what happened? After performing the neighborship, R1 will share update message. In its update message, it will forward the information regarding 10.1.1.0. 10.1.2.0, 10.1.3.0 prefix in its update message, right?
Yes.
Will it be shared the information regarding the 12 or not?
Yes.
No. The concept behind this, I'm not going to share the same information with the neighbor with using the same prefix I'm connected with my neighbor. Because about this prefix, my neighbor is already known. It's already known about it.
It's also
directly connected.
Directly connected.
Yeah. So I'm not going to share the 12 network information with R2. But here, suppose there is a router connected R3. Regarding the 12 information, I will inform
share.
It. Suppose it's not connected with the same prefix. Clear?
Yeah. No, but when we configure, for example, if we have router R1, R2, when we configure, right, we are advertising the network 12.1.1.0 network too, right? Aren't we?
What is the mean of network command? You have to discuss first. So you need to understand what was the use of network command. As I already said, I always informed you the use of network command. Like suppose you just use the network command like this, network 12.1.1.0.
Zero, yeah.
What is the mean of it? Router will find out on which interface the network of 12 is running. Okay, so okay. Suppose it's running over the F0/0. On this interface, now it's going to enable EIGR. Here, so it can share the EIGRP message over this interface. Okay, so
this 12 network won't advertise in the routing table, right?
It's depend from to which neighbor I'm going to share my update message. Suppose our scenario is like this. Here you need to understand this. Like suppose we have some router connected like this. Control. Okay. Now. Suppose it's connected like this.
Okay.
R1, R2. Behind the R1, there is a connected network of 20.1.1.0. And R2 will become the neighbor of, if I talk about the neighbor table, it's become the neighbor of R1 and R3. Just suppose.
Okay.
Here I'm using the 12 network information, 12.1.1.0 prefix. Here I'm using 23. Right. Suppose when I will forward the update message toward the R3. In the routing table of R2, there will be three entry like directly connected network like 12.1.1.0.
Zero, yes.
Like it's 0/0. There is an entry of 20.1.1.0. Suppose it's your loopback. 23.1.1.0. With suppose 0/1. Okay, so when I try to forward my data, or we can say when I try to forward my update message to whom? R3.
R3
is connected via which link?
0/1.1.1.0.
By using this prefix. Okay, so the information I'm going to share, or we can say the prefix I'm going to share, will be like 12.1.1.0 and 20.1.1.0 only. When I try to share the update message to R1, I will check by using which prefix I'm connected with R1. So rather than this, I will share another prefixes like 23.1.1.0.
Yeah, God. I'm sorry. Actually, I thought in the hello message it will be sending the this information. You're talking about the update message. Yeah, yeah. Update, it will try to update only. Okay, we just start. Okay.
Hello, carrying some parameters we already discussed. Some sequence number and some acknowledgement number, which always be zero, like some parameters, metric weights. Some hold down time.
Hold down timer authentication, yeah.
There are so many things we already discussed.
Yeah, we are. No, what I know when that's what I'm recalculating it. So when you send a hello message, it will try to have this 12.1.1.1
and then
yeah, yeah. Now it's an update message. It'll try to share what are the not directly connected.
Okay. So here R2 will maintain the routing table like there is a connected via DD means EIGR.
Okay.
10.1.1.0 prefix which containing some AD like 90, containing some metric like 100, connected via 12.1.1.1 by using its stepper. There is another prefix via EIGR
10.1.2.0 with AD
100 via 12.1.1.1. There is another prefix 10.1.3.0 90 100 connected via 12.1.1.1. Clear now? Okay. So this will be the routing table of R2. Now what happened? Suppose the prefix running behind the R1 of 10.1.2.0 goes down. This prefix goes down. So my neighbor is 12.1.1.2. What is my responsibility to update my neighbor that a prefix which connected via me directly is down? Now, clear? What is my responsibility? I just need to update my neighbor that there was a prefix which goes down now. So what I will do, I will generate an query message just to inform my neighbor that the prefix of 10.1.2.0 goes down. Please down this neighbor if you store the prefix by using me. Okay. And how it will share the information that this prefix goes down? It will use delay as infinite. That the delay comes the infinite for this prefix. So what the R2 will understand, this query message coming from 12.1.1.1, this query message is coming from 12.1.1.1 and it's containing the information of 10.1.2.0. In this, delay is infinity. That means this prefix goes down. Is it stored via 12.1.1.1 in my routing table? Yes. If it's stored via 12.1.1.1 in my routing table, what I will do, I will remove this prefix. Clear this one?
Yeah.
That's it practically.
Delay will be go for infinity.
Yes.
Any network.
I'm going to start it again. Behind the R1, I'm going to use some loopback like loopback 1, like 10.1.1.1. I hope you know about the loopback. What are the loopbacks? Okay. You know, 10.1.0 prefix. There will be a loopback 2 like 10.1.2.0. The loopback 3. 10.1.3.0. Here, These prefixes are connected behind the R. It's a wrong result. It's old result. So I think there is a technical issue in my GNS. Okay, it's also an old result. So I think I need to restart my GNS. Okay, so let me start it again. Excuse me. Hello, Anu sir. नहीं यार अभी मैं क्लास में बस थोड़ी देर में फ्री होने वाला हूँ. अच्छा क्या बोल रहे हैं. अच्छा अच्छा तो डाल तो फिर अपन लोग दोबारा बोल ही दिया तो यार क्या डालना है. तो उसमें ऐसे लिख देना सॉरी टू से बट देर वॉज सम टेक्निकल इशू सो आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू prepare my PPT also. Okay, not even able to start my PC. Not even able to start my system. There was some critical technical issues. Is tarike se dalna. Okay, I'm really sorry for this.
It's okay.
I hope you understand. Okay. So is tarike se aap dal do wahan pe. Haan. I hope you understand. ठीक है इस तरीके से डाउन इवन आई एम ट्राइंग टू रिजॉल्व द इशू बट इट्स नॉट वर्किंग इस तरीके से ठीक है
पीसी द
Zero by zero or here okay first let me check showing me the old result or the new. Okay good now it's working now zero by zero here I'm going to use no shift command first and I'm going to use the IP address like 12.1.1.1 ff.0 now shut the r2 0 by 0 or here I'm going to use the IP address like 12.1.1.1 now shut okay for the r1 I'm going to use some loopback like IP address 10.1.1.1 back to 2.1 let's loop back 3 sorry let's loop back 3 sorry let's loop back 3 3.1 add mask okay user interface section excluded unsigned okay. Clear? Let's come to the R2. You can verify over here. It's like. IP configured over here. It's like 12.1.1.2. What I'm going to do, I'm going to enable the EIGRP process. So, router EIGRP. It's like. Okay. Over here, I'm using the network command. Like 0.0.0.0. Or here I'm going to use the router EIGRP and the same network command. And they'll become the neighbor and R2 show IP EIGRP. The prefixes I received from my neighbor are like to show IP route. These prefixes with the ID and with a metric. Clear?
Okay. Yeah.
By using which interface I am receiving these prefixes? By using F0 by. Clear. D means
EIGRP. EIGRP, right? Yeah, D. It's learned by EIGRP.
Okay. Now what I'm going to do here, you can check
R1
chat message. Okay. What I'm going to do on R1, I'm going to come on
interface loop back to.
Down this interface. Bring up down. Down. Okay. So I'm going to stop this message. This capturing. Here you will see 12.1.1.1. Just generate an query message. Let's come to the R2. To show IP route. Before checking the new routing table, you can verify over here there is a prefix of 10.1.2.0.
Zero. Okay.
Here. Now, what I'm going to use this command to check the new routing table. Yeah, or we can update it routing table. There is no prefix information regarding the 10.1.2.0. How the R2 will come to know that 10.1.2.0 is goes down? R1 will generate a query message. Clear? R1 will generate a query message. Let's check it out. Come to the Wireshark. Here you will see there is a query message. Visible? It's a query message.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So let's check it out. I'm going to use this query message. It's a query message. Opcode is 3. There is a prefix of 10.1.2.0. Its sequence number is 3. Okay, note it down. And internal route 10.1.2.0 with CIDR value 24. Here you will see the delay.
Where it is. Observe priority reliability load delay infinity. Yes,
the delay is infinity. What is the mean of it? When the R2 will receive this query message, R2 will thought the it's I'm just receiving a query message with whom? 12.1.1.1 from my neighbor. And how I just installed the prefix information of 10.1.2.0 in my routing table via my neighbor 12.1.1.1, and what the query message tried to told me that 10.1.2.0 prefix having the delay infinite. That means this prefix goes down. So what the R2 will do, R2 will check the prefixes coming from the query message. is connected via the same neighbor or not? Yes, it's connected via the same neighbor. So what the R2 will do? R2 will remove its prefix information from the routing table. Clear to you guys?
Yes.
So, okay. So that was the use case of query messages.
If you have another router, if you have a R3.
We'll discuss.
Okay.
Query is not yet completed.
Oh, okay.
There is another use of query message. First, as we discussed, to inform neighbor. That the specific prefix goes down. If you have stored in your routing table that prefix by using me, please remove it immediately. Clear? Now we will discuss the another use of query message. What is the another case? To ask the neighbor about that prefix. If you have stored that prefix in your your routing table with some other neighbor, please let me know. Understand? Like, to understand this, just suppose behind the R3 behind the R2 there is a router connected like this, R3, and behind the R3 there was a prefix of 10.1.2.0. Okay, so the same prefixes receiving via R1 and same prefixes receiving via R3. But suppose in my routing table, suppose the 10.1.2.0 prefix coming with the metric 150, and over here I'm receiving the same prefixes 10.1.2.0 with metric 100. Which prefix I store in my routing table? 10.1.2.0 prefix via R3. Obvious, because it's coming with the lowest metric. So I'm just taking an example. The same prefixes advertised by the R1 and advertised by the R3. But the R3 is advertising that prefix with the lowest metric. So
it should not advertise, right?
It should not.
Whom? No. See, we have from R1, they're advertising the 10.1, 10.1.2, 10.1.3. And R2 also will advertise the same thing. But R3 should advertise this back 10.1.2.0 network.
No. Actually, let's start from the beginning. Suppose there are three routers. Just we have three routers, R1, R2, and R3. R1 having some prefixes of 10's network like this.
Okay.
First, it perform the neighborship with R2. R2 perform the neighborship with whom?
R3. R1 and R3.
Okay, R3 perform the neighborship whom? With whom?
R2. R2.
Okay, so R1 will advertise some prefixes information. Just again an urgent call. Yes, sir. What's up? Okay, guys, continue. Karte. Okay, guys, let's continue. Suppose, so here R1 will share the update message regarding the 10.1.1.0 prefix information, 10.1.2.0 prefix information, 10.1.3.0 prefix information with some AD and with some metric. Suppose it's sharing the metric 150. Okay, so R2 just received three prefixes from the R1. Okay, and R3 is going to advertise the network of 10.1.2.0. I'm just using these prefix to understand the thing only. Even if you want, you can use the information of all the prefix, like it's connected the old same prefix, like 10.1.1.0, 10.1.2.0, 10.1.3.0.
Yes.
It's same ID. And the metric are like 100. In that case, from which path R2 will maintain the routing table. Why using whom? R1 or R3? It will maintain its routing table like there is a prefix of 10.1.2.0 which is connected via R3. I will receive the prefix from R3. I will maintain my routing table via R3 because it's the metric is lowest as compared to R2. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
Now in that case, suppose this prefix goes down, or we can say the same prefix as we used in our last scenario, like the prefix of 10.1.2.0 goes down.
Okay.
What is my responsibility to update my neighbor that there was a prefix behind me is goes down. So what I will do, I will update. I will generate a query message. And what was the use behind this query message? That there was a prefix of 10.1.2.0. Over here, the delay is
infinity.
That means this one goes down. That means if you is installed the same prefix in your routing table, why using me? Please remove it immediately. But if I talk about the routing table of R2, the same prefix received by the another neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
So what the R2 will do? R2 will reply to R1. So it will generate a message called as reply.
Okay.
Okay. In this reply message, it will share the same prefix information, which was goes down. That it's having the metric to me, which was like 100. You can install this prefix information in your routing table. Clear?
So in R2, you'll have two paths. One is for 10.1.2.0 524 via, it's coming from 0 by 0 with a metric of 150. And yes, there'll be another routing. There will be another routing table with it, right? For 10.1.2.0 via F0/0 with a metric value of 100. There'll be two routing tables.
No, why it's containing the two routing table? It
two routes.
If you are talking about, yes, there will be two routes in its routing table.
Yeah, two
from
routes.
R1 and R2, not the two routing table.
Yeah, two routes will be there. But even now also I'm wondering,
in its routing table there will be a single prefix regarding the tens network. Why using vote R3? Cause it's receiving from a lowest metric. There will be no two prefix. There will be a single prefix which having lowest metric, but it's in topology table. Might be there will be two prefixes.
Okay, but it will ping. See, when if 10.1.2. network is down, okay, someone is trying to ping to 10.1.2. network, it will try to ping from R1 to R3.
Yes. Of course, now it's connected via 10.1.2.0. When this prefix goes down, it will be connected via R2. Because in the reply message, R2 reply that it's connected via me, you can hand over me if you want to go for 10.1.2.0. So the another use of query message, please let me know if you have installed that prefix information in your routing table. So what was the information in the query message regarding the prefix 10.1.2.0? If you have this prefix information in your routing table regarding the same prefix by using some another neighbor, please let me know.
So it will try to get the 10.1.2.0. That's a reply query and reply message, right?
Yes, it's a reply message.
Okay, then it will update in its routing table, right? Then the 10.1.2.0 slash it will update in its routing table.
Yes, R1 will update its routing table via R2.
Yes. No longer will be, initially it was a 10.1.2.0, it's directly connected. Now it will update routing table 10.1.2.0 via R2. Okay.
Okay, so we can check it.
Yeah. Eager to see this in the lab.
Yeah, we will see it practically on another day because it will take time and we don't have much time to understand these things.
I'll try to do that.
Okay, so we'll do it tomorrow.
Sure.
I hope everything is clear to you.
Yes.
Any doubt, Brian?
No, sir.
No. Why you are always in silent mode? Might be you are good in understanding way, or might be you don't want to ask anything.
No, sir. Okay. If I have queries, I'll ask.
So you don't have any query right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please have some query. We already discussed the query message.
So these are only four messages: hello, update, query, and reply.
Oh, there is another message acknowledged, but we don't. So I'm not able to show you the acknowledged message code. Today, the hello is used as acknowledged also. But there was a time, if I talk about, if we use the iOS before 15.0. They used acknowledge as a different message, but after 15.0 iOS, we use hello as a acknowledged.
Okay.
In the hello message, if it's using as a keep alive, always acknowledge zero. But if used as a acknowledged message, there will be some acknowledged value. Acknowledge. Okay. So I hope it's clear to you.
Yes.
Let's meet tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay, bye. See you.
Bye. Yeah. Bye.